Yes, I gotta do it on here. So, this video is for shit. I didn't record this shit like 20 times.
Yeah, and it go a little something.
Like that.
Run away, love. Run away, love. Run away.
For my babies that suffer with mental health, stress, suicidal, all of this, I got some words for y'all today. I feel like God put it on my heart to speak to y'all because I go through the same shit. One, if you're feeling stressed, you feel like, what the fuck am I doing in life? I just feel like everything I'm doing is wrong. Everything everything gets to you, just life is not going well for you. You are not in a place where you need to be. You're depressed, you're in a black hole, you're in a dark hole. I wanna speak to y'all. I wanna speak to y'all because, man, I wish that I had somebody to speak to me. It's not easy going through the phases of damaged mental health. It's not fun, it's not easy, but it's going to be okay. Understand that you can train your brain to do whatever. The first step to eliminating depression is getting negative thoughts out your mind. And you cannot depend on anyone to do this for you, or you will stress yourself out even more. And I get very emotional on this subject because this is serious to me. You have to sit down with yourself. And you have to understand that if it was you on the other hand, how would you feel about yourself? And don't think the regular thoughts that you have been thinking. How would you view yourself? That's number one, because one thing about it is always something that you can change. It's always something that you can change. How do you view yourself? I'm talking to myself. Myself say who says self. Nah, but I'm talking to myself, and I'm trying to get to know me. Once you start to do that, then you start to align your soul with your brain. Because, see, your brain can be trained so much to the point where you act off a reaction. You act off of what your brain is used to. Once you sit down with yourself and you make yourself aware of who you really are, well, then your brain starts to say, well, we need to do something a little bit different. Some ain't right. I'm not talking about nothing else but depression, my suicidal victims, my babies who feel like nobody is here for you. I'm here for you. I wish I could touch you and hug you. I wish I could kiss you on your forehead. But I'm going to say a prayer for you tonight. I promise. I come to realize that I'm not the only one that's dealing with this, but let's go back to where we were. So you sit down with yourself and you acknowledge, okay, this is me. The second part of this is you need to write. Not type, not speak, that's coming later, but you need to write out how you feel on a daily basis for 7 days. A lot of people say 30 days, you will break a habit in 7 days. You need to write down every morning, every lunch, every dinner, how you are feeling. You don't necessarily have to be depressed at the moment. Most people who go through depression are only depressed at night. They're only depressed when they're alone. You need to write down how you feel so that you can see how you feel and your brain can see that as well. I feel sad. I feel like no one has my back. Why is no one ever here? No one understands me. But you have to understand that if you want to improve your mental health and you want to crawl out of depression, remember what I told you, no one else can do this for you. So when you're writing down and you start to see that all you're doing is pointing the fingers at people and you don't see not an eye on that paper, something's not right. And and we gotta start over. This needs to be a self thing. You cannot depend on another person for your happiness. This needs to be a self thing. So you're gonna write out morning, let's say breakfast, lunch, and dinner. You need to write that out. I feel this way. I feel this way. Whether it's a sentence or 100 sentences, you need to write it out. The second step, you need to pray. I'm sorry, the third step, you need to pray. I know some of y'all might not believe in God, but y'all gonna believe in God today. Because no matter what, whoever believes in God, when they pray, they speak out. That's the main thing that you need to do. You need to speak out. Not to other people. You've had enough of that. You've had enough of telling people how you feel, and it don't matter. They're not gonna feel the way that you feel. They're gonna give their advice, but they're not gonna feel that depression and that hurt and that sad that's in your body. They don't feel that. They might feel bad for you. They don't feel what you feel. So when you speak that out to whether it's you want it to be God, whether you want it to be yourself, whether it's something that you want to practice talking to somebody about. You fix it. You speak that out. So after you spoke it out, okay, so we have us a routine going on now. We've sat down with ourselves. We wrote down how we feel. We prayed about it. We spoke out about it. Well, what's next? Because ain't nothing changed. I'm still depressed, still sad. I still don't understand what the fuck. Well, you got to keep that in rotation. Consistency is key. So now you've written it down. You spoke it out. You know who you are. Now we need to make solutions for problems. I'm going to give y'all an example. I'll use my relationship for example. Joseph gets on my damn nerves. I love my baby to death. I'm never leaving him. I've said negatives and positives at the same time. If you are a person that is depressed and that is sad, you cannot do that. Everything that comes out of your mouth needs to be positive. Of course, every boyfriend gets on every girlfriend's nerves. Every girlfriend gets on every boyfriend's nerve. But that's not something that we need to speak out. That's not something that we need to write down. That's not something that we need to sit down with. Somebody getting on your nerves. We need to sit down with, I love him, I'll never leave him. We need to write down, I love him, I'll never leave him. We need to speak out, I love him, I'll never leave him. If it's positive. This is for the girls. Y'all know what I'm talking about. If that's not a person that you don't need to be with, this ain't for you. You need to write down, I'm better than this. I don't need him. I'm better than this. I'm moving on. That's for y'all, but we'll get there. But that's y'all have to understand that when y'all start coming up with these solutions for these problems, everything is solved. Everything is solved. Now your brain has taught yourself that it is a solution for the problem that you have going on. You're sad, it's a solution for that. You want to kill yourself, it's a solution for that. My daddy always told me, and I'm not making fun of suicidal people because I've been suicidal. So I'm speaking to you because I feel for you and I love you, but you got to understand that sometimes we got to come to face ourselves. Sometimes it's not about the world caring about our happiness, because they never care about our happiness. My daddy always used to tell me, if you're going to kill yourself, kill yourself. Do it. Don't say it. Do it. A person that really wants to kill themselves, they're going to do it. They're not going to play. They might plan it, but they're going to do it. So if you feel like leaving this earth is what's going to make you happy and it's going to wipe all your pain away, but is that really what you want? You want to be happy, right? You want all your pain to be wiped away, right?
Hey guys, it looks like my camera went out. I ran out of video time. So actually, I just wanted to tell y'all that I hope y'all enjoyed my little advice to give to y'all. I have many more videos to come. I'm very excited to talk about certain topics about my life. I know that it can be shared to others and help others. Mental health and, you know, depression. Being sad, being alone, feeling alone is a serious situation. Suicidal is a serious situation, and I want everyone to take this serious. Check on your friend, check on your family, love everyone the same way you would want to be loved.